Pass through is Peverly, and so it can be carried back out by Steven Stamkos. Oh, and a hit on him by Boychuk.
There's Steven Stamkos, and this is just outstanding technique there by Johnny Boychuk. At the last second, Steven Stamkos tried to cut back to the middle. And Boychuk just met him at impact.
Marchand run into by Le Cavalier, bounces off Berenson's shot. That canceled out as Brewer was reaching at it. Oh, and what a hit there. And then coming over, and Cronwall responds with a shove and a punch at Le Cavalier, and that's probably what the referee spotted.
There's Johnny Boychuk, steps right in. Simo Gagné, head is down. A good, clean, hard hit. You see LeCavier, he comes over to answer to Johnny Boychuk.
Let's remember, Simo Gagné got hurt in the Washington series off a hard, solid hit by Scotty Hannon. And then Boychuk retaliates against LeCavier.
Yeah, the punch.
That's a clean hit.
And watch, look.
Those guys are dropping in front of shots. It's not only sets a good example, but and so back ahead it's Carey. Trying to escape ball and getting a big strong shot on ball. Out of all of that, the Thomas angle. Boy, that was a good charge by Teddy Purcell. And there was the jam up trying for the rebound as Thomas was able to make the stop.
And now you got Steve Downey and Zdeno Chara going at it. And if you're Zdeno Chara, you don't want to get tangled up with Steve Downey, because Steve Downey has done his job. He's taken Zdeno Chara off the ice for the next 2 minutes.
Hard to charge till next. Steer it right back ahead to Mark Recchi. Ooh, a collision there. Recchi. Cavalier had that knifed off by Chara. Two big men outside by Marchand and dealt back out again. And Marchand scurries back. Stamkos got it. Moving on across. Oh, and he collides with Thomas. The net is dislodged. And what are we going to get? A cross-checking call.
They call it Ferentz or Stamkos?
Well, it's got to be on Andrew Ferentz.
Because when Dan O'Rourke makes his call, I have no idea who he's pointing at or who he's talking to.
Well, Brad Marchand never looks over his right shoulder. And here comes Steven Stamkos. Looks like he shot out of a cannon. And there you see the cross check. I think it actually...
Smith, he's without his stick and his shot. It's blocked away to the corner by San Luis. Tucked out in front, and Smith dives out and hangs on to it. Little extra hit there. Little ill will. Fans standing and waving the yellow towels.
And if you're Boston, you need something. After the good chance for Nathan Horton, Michael Reiner had one. Right off a face-off, and here you see Nathan Horton chops the stick out of the hands of Mike Smith. Could have easily been a penalty. And then David Krejci comes in. His puck is losing. Look at Mike Smith.
There will be a siren and a celebration forthcoming. That's it, and a little extra after the horn sounds. Decided on peace until next time. The linesmen get in between the... And the fans applaud. San Luis straight...
It looked like pond hockey there for a second. The puck's down there somewhere, and Char is ready to go with Alexiak. Yeah, here we go! 6-9 against 6-7. Oh, the uppercut from Chara. Oh, he hurt him again. Alexiak looking for something. Chara over the top. Alexiak can't reach the captain. He's yapping at him. Chara goes to the body. Wants to tear his head off. Yeah, all right. Enough.
From Downey, we explained this in the last game. Now Chara's gonna go. He's just about sick and tired of this little punk. Oh man, the big guy is just unloading. Downey says, where am I? Mommy, help.
Just what we talked about, Jack, after he dropped the gloves.
Tosses it ahead, here's Fulton. Oh. Fulton, go
he's had about enough of that. Linesman Scott Cherry right in there. Tuukka Rask, not gonna wait. Comes out and decides to play it aggressively. Alex Formanton goes sailing over the top for Alex Formanton to go.
Oh, he does absolutely nothing wrong. And if this was the other way around and it was a Bruin trying to get to a loose puck and Condon came out, you'd be surprised maybe at the response by Moore. I mean, there's nothing he can do. He's going for that puck.
Kevin Miller and Jujhar Khaira squaring off. This could be a pay-per-view event. Miller engages. Khaira misses with the big right. Miller with the jabs gets Kara's hat off. They trade hooks. Nothing reaching yet. Miller scores. Khaira might be leaking. Khaira trying to get a hold of Miller. And they'll break it up.
Khaira on the receiving end of the Chris Wagner hit. Khaira came back. He knocked down John Moore in that first period from behind. A lot going on at ice level, and Kara's right in the middle of it. And Kevin Miller's going to do his job, that if he wants a dancing partner, Kevin Miller will definitely oblige in order to have his teammates' backs.
He lugs it over the red line, bounces it in deep with 2.5 to go in the second period, and the panel of glass comes out as Matt Benning was on the receiving end. I think it was Corrali.
It was Corrali, and he's coming with a ton of speed. This is where you hope that you're able to run a little interference for your D partner, but you can't in today's game, and he's going to try to avoid getting him on the numbers. As Benning goes back to make a play along the glass, Corrali wants to finish his hit, and you got to avoid making contact on the numbers. Get him from the side. The referee is right there, Jack.
Horvat drops Nordstrom, and Achari and Horvat are going to go. Horvat can take care of himself. They see him as a future captain here. Achari's taking the worst of it. Now he counters with the left, gets in a couple of jackhammer shots, and flips it.
Potential 2-on-0, but the puck stuck in the snow. Carlo recovers against Kadri. Marleau picks it off along the boards. Nylander to Marleau, a quick release, and Halak is square to the shot. Now Kadri offering with Carlo. The gloves are off. Oh, Carlo! Good strong rights. Kadri trying to throw lefts, not connecting. Carlo has him pinned.
Opponents because they can be so physical. It's a great hit by Miller. Tkachuk had a chance. If he wanted to do anything, he was going to complete his line change. Then Frohley came at it, thought better of it because it's.
Yeah, here we go. Kevin Miller, Nick Delorier. Delorier started his career as a defenseman, converted to forward. Miller, who's missed considerable time this season. All time here, no doubt about it. Delorier, they both respond, lefts and rights. How about that?
Alley, Perreault swivels it. Miller buries Tanev, and Miller's gonna go with Lowry. Oh boy, this is a heavyweight match. Lowry with a slight reach advantage. These are two big punchers here. Miller, the jabs. Lowry, the hook, goes over and under. Tries to get the helmet off. Miller goes body. Lowry with the uppercut. Miller pushes him to the boards. And Carlo muscles the puck out of the zone. Sherratt off Frederick, who was ready for the shoulder-to-shoulder hit. Tyler Myers swipes it around. And the puck drops down in the corner. Grizzlick to Frederick, smartly to Heinen. Gets Myers a little off his angle, fires wide. Carlo tosses it middle, Backus on the bouncer, And Heinen takes a hand pass and shovels it off the pipe. Now Back is shoving with Sherratt. And Myers pairs off with Frederick, and Tanev wants a piece of Frederick. Frederick's willing to go. Frederick with the uppercut gets Tanev's helmet off. Oh, oh, look at him go. Welcome to Boston, Trent Frederick. Just rock 'em, sock 'em, robots. Listen to the crowd at TD Garden. Bob and Gabe Frederick.
TJ Oshie. And that was Kuznetsov who coughed it up. What a hit by Wagner on Oshie. He's lost his helmet in the process now, Kuznetsov.
We're back here in Washington. Well, my partner, Mike Milbury's from Walpole, Massachusetts, went to Colgate, and for some reason, sure, no bias, want to talk about Chris Wagner.
Well, he's also from Walpole and Colgate, but what are you insinuating here, John? There's no bias. This is a good-looking player, and it's given responsibility to the script there, shorthanded, almost had a great scoring. Will did have a good scoring opportunity. Walks it out front to the troublesome area, and right there, boom, knocks off.
Vado Chara, cross ice for Charlie Coyle. Coyle with a shot, and that's handled by Louis Domingue. And now some extracurricular activity. David Backes and Adam Ernie, they drop the gloves.
Second fight in two games for Backes.
By Marshall. Well, one good shift in a row. Charlie McAvoy around the circle. He and Panarin behind the play. And Panarin and McAvoy are going to go. McAvoy taking on Panarin. Panarin a couple of wild swings. McAvoy just trading over and under. McAvoy tees off. Purpose.
Matt Martin and Sedano Chara have dropped the mitts. Neither man wears a visor. Two of the long-standing tough guys in the NHL. Oh, Chara with the monster reach, and Martin, a trademark, bouncing right back up. Chara tags him again. He's got a sleeve length of about 50 inches. They trade. Just one of the strong, just for fun. Achari with a couple of lefts. It's rock 'em, sock 'em, robots. And Achari just puddles Weegar. Unanimous decision. No need for punch. faces up for grabs. Listen to the crowd. Finally managing some second period zone time, and tempers flare after the whistle. What took them so long? The clock winds to zero, and the two teams, which know each other well, and there is growing contempt for one another.
That linesman's got to get that stick out of there and down before it gets in somebody's face.
Down to the corner, and Coyle flattens Hainsey.
Russell, a bit of a test there between Corrali.
As we see Nordstrom. Series.
Corrali fed one across that's punted aside by Bobrovsky, gotten by Achari. Line up back up by Werenski, carried back on by Chad.
Last words are not
wise, but that was about it. Did you ever try one of those?
In junior, I did my last year. I had the trainer sew on extensions and make it bigger in the armpit so that if there was a puck that went through the seven hole, this might hold up a little bit.
Atkinson's stick has been broken in anger, and so he will get another. 3:33 gone in overtime number one, and Marchand with a little hook on Atkinson. Back out. Tangled up in front. Kukin fed back across to Zingle, and then on over to Savard. His shot hit off the chest of Rask. And he's able to hang on, and Moore rocking around the crossbar near him. That one had gone in and bounced out, but it did ricochet off the post. And very alertly, the referee on the goal line saw it that way. Puck came back over to Werenski. Slides it across. Bjorkstrand's shot turned aside by Rask. And the horn sounds, and there's a little extra because crowding into Rask, he felt, and his teammates feel, was Dubois. Part of this series so far, and there have been more hits than shots on goal. Scott Harrington, one generous shot, and a save made by Rask. And a little extra coming.
At the other end of the ice is Josh Anderson with a cross check across the back of Charlie McAvoy. That's
jostled off enough with Jenner. Then along to Marchand, but he couldn't stop it. Jones there took a stick from Marchand, threw one that is batted down. Sent on back now for a shot. Knocked down by Rask and covered, and a penalty is coming up against the Bruins. And now an exchange between Foligno and Rask, and a crowd is gathering. Dive, and that one is held by Rask through a screen, and there's more after the whistle. Panarin lobbing one ahead, hoping for Anderson. Oh, and Anderson run to the ditch by McAvoy, and there'll be a penalty coming from that. Anderson is down on all fours on the ice and shaken up. The trainer immediately out there, and the question will be how much the penalty will be.
Anderson right here, and he does make pretty solid contact with Anderson's jaw.
I expect a major.
Sent back in by Martinuk and then played on first. Plaster job done there on Fogel. And we get a stoppage of play and a little more right in front of Brian Boucher at center ice. The physical part of the game picking up.
And help out.
Offside pass. Williams just holds, dishes in. A try by Berlin is blocked off and then eventually covered.
Saw the Dallas and St. Louis series, didn't we?
McKegg went driving into the net. It looks as though Rask is holding on to one hip. The net is dislodged.
Looked like the puck went in, Doc, from my vantage point. A burst of speed. Nice play by Martinuk. Here comes McKegg.
They are talking it over down there. I did not see an animated goal signal at all. Ended up in front and smothering that one is Mrazek, and a crowd gathers.
And now Carolina's going to go on the power play.
And remember, Svechnikov missed time with a concussion in the fight.
Hit on by Rask.
Well, there's Patrice Bergeron. Yeah, he gets drilled from behind from Jordan Martinook, and you see Martinook's reaction. So Bergeron says, you know what? You drilled me from behind. I'm going to
carry back up by Fogle. Warren Fogle able to step free, but then he a shoulder by Coyle on Fleury. Rattled it on further for the pass across, and Walmart can't clear out. Worked onto the outside on back. Slavin, a shot and a save made by Rask. Carried back ahead, but a penalty is coming up. It's going to be on the Hurricanes delayed call. Wagner able to bring it on, slip it on through, paddled away by Mrazek. And so now the penalty will be called.
It's going to be on Justin Williams. Him and Marchand were going at it, and they're still giving it.
Williams and Marchand get tangled up. Williams to the box, and you see Williams retaliate right here, rips off the chin strap of Brad Marchand. He knows the penalty is coming, and watch Marchand. Says, get to the box.
You're sent back ahead eventually, but the Bruins are carried on by Bergeron. Bergeron tucked it on across. Scores! What a beautiful! And a crowd after. By Rask.
So when you're facing an aggressive penalty-killing unit.
Net Williams with the...
There's another one. Got it around in front of me. Who's able to hang on? What a performance by him. And now more ugliness after that play.
Niederreiter and Coyle going at it. Niederreiter's been right in the middle. And then Crew got an extra. So a 5-on-4.
A backhander is cut off by Rask. The net is dislodged. The crowd gathers. And again, play is
of the shorthanded amount of time on a two-minute penalty. Well, now the line has been...
Hitchman gets in between. They are eye to eye.
Play was offside.
And now Barbashev comes back and wants to do something with Clifton.
If you're the Bruins, you don't want to get in anything like this against... If you're the Blues, you don't want to... Or the Bruins, you don't want to get in anything... Barbashev and Clifton.
floated back high, and it plops near Shen. Give it on over to Schwartz, and getting a piece of that and directing it out of play was Tuukka Rask. Side play, a shot, and that one wouldn't go. And we get a stoppage of play as the net is dislodged, and now Perron is in on Rask, and that will draw a crowd.
And after they came up, here's Barbashev putting the brusque into the Bruins bench, almost a little push back there.
Petrangelo giving on back again. Edmondson, a shot, stopped there by Rask, covered by Rask, and more nudging toward Rask. And we're going to get a penalty coming up out of all of this, and maybe more after the whistle, because it seems that Kelly Sutherland has lost his patience.
Yeah, and I think it's got to be David Perron. Remember, David Perron bumped into Tuukka Rask? Watch how this play finishes. Perron is there, no problem, okay, everybody's battling, but now he falls into Rask, and then he gives him a quick little shot as he comes down right there with his left hand. We're screened out on that look, and that's where the penalty happened.
Yeah, we're gonna have that. Ahead and put on the stick of Sammy Blais again. Blais with a pass that's directed away by the stick of Krejci. Sent back to Perron, and a save is made by Rask, and a crowd gathers after all. To keep it alive.
Good thing he did show heads up.
Tarasenko off the side of the net. It is pinned by Rask, and play is stopped, but the action is not. Go Blues chant. One more time while the team is in activity in front of them. We're going to get a slashing call here, and now a crowd gathering.
Yeah, Sammy Playwood had the initial slash on Connor Clifton.
Officials are on top of board, Doc. Sorry.
No, that's all right. The official's just trying to keep a lid on. And
Clifton, high hit by Clifton. There's the slash. There's going to be a penalty there.